So, I'm leaving Kyoto Dabe to embark on a little mini adventure. I haven't done one of these in years. I'm heading to the Shimanami Kaido. I'm gonna try and bike it. It's just me. It was a last minute plan because my office didn't let me know that I could take off this week until just Friday night, late night, made the booking, and then it's Sunday and I'm off to Onomichi, which is the starting point. We'll stay overnight there and then leave tomorrow morning early. The problem is I made a big mistake. It's my fault. I thought round trip was 70 kilometers. So one way from Onomichi to Imabari was only 35 kilometers. And I thought, wow, geez, I can do that. But after I made all the bookings of the hotels last night, I came to find out that it's 70 kilometers one way. So round trip is 140 kilometers. And it was already too late because I had booked all my hotels or our guest houses along the way and I had paid already. There's no way I can cancel, no refund. So tomorrow I'm gonna have to try and ride at 70 kilometers one way and make it to Imabari and stay overnight there. So that's my only concern. Anyway, I'm leaving Kyoto Nabe now. Gonna take the train to Kyoto Station. Hey everyone, I'm here in Onomichi staying overnight. Tomorrow morning I leave, maybe 7 a.m. I'll pick up the bicycle and start the long journey to Imabari, which is about over 70 kilometers away. Today I came from Kyoto. I took the Shinkansen, got off at Fukuyama. That was about an hour and maybe 5-6 minutes. And then I transferred to the JR line, the local train. It's 4 stops from Fukuyama to Onomichi, about 20-25 minutes. And walked over to the hotel. I'm staying in the Green Hills Hotel, which is about 3-star hotel, business hotel. You know, nothing special or anything. Stay here one night and take off tomorrow. When I arrived today, I couldn't check in. In Japan, they're very strict, right? 3 o'clock check-in. I think there's only been like one hotel out of hundreds that I've stayed in Japan that have actually let me in early. That was really unusual. Most of the places are very strict about protecting that 3 o'clock, and you know, no one wants to change that, even though I argued that a lot of times it makes more sense to let the guests go up so they don't have to come back again or keep coming and asking you. But it was 3 o'clock. So then I went to the rental shop. You know, I couldn't make reservations online because they were full, so I was worried that maybe I can't get a bicycle. But when I had emailed them, they wrote back, but the English was a little strange. But I assumed that, you know, maybe bicycles come in and maybe all of the bicycles are not on the reservation list. And then I came and I met a gentleman by the name of Iwamoto, Mr. Iwamoto. And he was an older gentleman, nice guy. And just so happened, there was a Singapore lady there and she couldn't speak Japanese and his English was very limited. So I helped interpret for them. And you know, she wanted to know about their sending her luggage or baggage. She had a big backpack to Imabari. And so I helped with that. And then after, he was quite thankful. And then he said, well, you have to come tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. It's 2,000 yen a day for the bicycle. And there's another 1,100 yen for, it's like a deposit. It's a refundable deposit in case you don't return the bicycle back to Onomichi. Then I think that they take that. If you return the bicycle back to Onomichi, then that gets refunded back to you. So it's 2,000 yen a day. If I'm gonna go for 3 days, so that's 6,000 plus the 1,100. So 7,100 was what he had said to me. And I told him I wanted a basket because I have a backpack. You know, I have this kind of big backpack. And also I wanted a rack on the back and not too thick because I had these panniers, I think they call them panniers, which go on to the bicycle on the rack. They go onto the rack here. And they slip on here. These are from my trip from 29 years ago to Hokkaido, REI. And that was with Dao from Argentina, Titis from Indonesia, and Usui-san from Japan. These are the only mementos I have of that trip. Like when I went to visit Dao, who's now the governor of Catamarca in Argentina, when I went to visit him about 3 years ago, he still has his bicycle and his bicycle jersey and his shorts and all the different things from that trip. What I needed from Mr. Iwamoto was a basket and a rack, but all the bicycles are different. A lot of them are like cross trainers, cross runners, I don't know, city bikes. You know, they're more like sporty. They have no basket, of course, and they have no rack. But there's a few, what we call mama chari. Mama chari is mama charinko. Charinko is like old-fashioned style Japanese bike that goes karing 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 karing. That's why I think the word charinko comes from. And there weren't many. He let me actually test drive them. I don't know if everyone gets to do that, but that was really nice of him. I said, well, if tomorrow one of these two bikes are still available, then please, I'd like to have. And he said he'll be here tomorrow at 7 a.m. So I'm going to go down and hopefully that bicycle or one of the two will still be there. Now, it's very tricky because I don't know if I can do this or not. And earlier I had mentioned I made a mistake on this trip. It's 70 kilometers one way, so it's 140 kilometers, right? So that's about 85, 90 miles, you know, if you do the entire thing. But just going one way, it's about 43 miles, I believe. Even that though, I'm not sure if I can do that. It doesn't sound like that much, but I haven't been riding long. You know, I do exercise on the bike, but nothing like this. So the average, they say, is somewhere around 8 hours. And people who are beginners or really slow, maybe 10 hours. The problem now is that it's winter. And so the sun rises later, but it sets sooner. So today I was checking, it's about 5. I don't want to ride in the dark. You know, that if anything, that would be crazy. So I need to get there by 3, maybe 4 at the latest. So I'm trying to get out as soon as I can. At the same time, you know, I wanted to take some photos and some videos. And you know what's amazing is this Shimanami Kaido bicycle course or trip. It goes through 6 different islands, 6 different suspension bridges. And it goes from Hiroshima Prefecture to Ehime Prefecture, from Onomachi City to Imabari City, you know, the one way. It's an amazing trip. You know, I got this idea from Chris from his YouTube, Abroad in Japan. You know, he's a big YouTuber, right? He has thousands, hundreds of thousands of people following him. And I was watching the one he did on the Shimanami Kaido. And he had said it's one of the most beautiful places he's seen in Japan.
I've been incredibly lucky over the last 6 years to travel Japan extensively. But this is hands down the most beautiful place in all of Japan. No competition.
And the lady who was with him, Sharla, his cycling partner, she also has a YouTube channel, but she said she didn't have an answer whenever someone asked her, what's the most beautiful place in Japan? But after doing this trip, she said, it's this, Shimanami Kaido.
I can't explain the view in words. I honestly can't. It's the best thing I've ever seen in my entire life. And now when people ask me the one thing they should do when they come to Japan, I finally have an answer. I didn't have one until now. I always couldn't decide because there's so many cool things to do here. This is it. Cycle the Shimanami Kaido. If you don't want to cycle, if you can't cycle, rent a car, travel across it by walking, by wheelchair, however you can, please do it.
And so that's what I thought. You know, I've been in Japan 25 years. I hadn't seen it yet. And I thought that, okay, you know, some people do it by car, you can do it by bus, but you know, the real way is to do it by bicycle. Now, some people also walk it. You can walk it, it's gonna take you that much longer. But bicycling or cycling seems to be the best way to do the Shimanami Kaido. And it's built, you know, they have a bicycle path that's, you know, marked with blue. So you supposedly you just follow the blue all the way to Imabari. Now, my problem is that, you know, I'm packing here and I don't want to carry, as you know, you want to be as light as possible, right? And so a lot of people just bring, you know, the bare minimum. Problem is, if you want to take like video or camera, you know, there's a lot of stuff that I have. Things like, you know, batteries and, you know, chargers and, you know, cameras and gimbals, and they're heavy. That's one. And the other thing is, because this is November and it's not cold, but it's still pretty cool. In the mornings, it's about between 50 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's still cool. So you have to have some kind of, you know, warm jacket, not too thick. I had this great plan. And you know, maybe some of you who are not too sure you want to do this, or you don't want to carry things with you, or you know, you're not sure you can do the route. You know, I would suggest maybe, as the brochures say now I learned, they say break it up into 2 trips. So it's about 70 to 80 kilometers, right? So make it about 40 and you stay overnight here, and 40. You know, that's doable, right? So that's what I would suggest too. I haven't even done it yet, but that's what I would guess would probably be the best way, that you can leisurely cycle and you can stop in places. Because if you're doing the 8-hour route, you really don't have time to stop. And even for me to take photos or to do video, it takes time. So I have to limit that, you know, at least on the way down. When I come back, I have it broken up into 2 days, so I have a little more time. And I have clothes and I have camera stuff. I don't want to wear a backpack when I ride, because I always heard that it wasn't good for your back. So even in Hokkaido, I never wore a backpack. I just put it on the back rack and, you know, just kind of piled it up like a mountain. Well, first, from Kyoto to here, I did Takyubing, Yamato or Kuroneko. And from Kyoto to here, it was somewhere about 1400 yen, which was quite reasonable, $10-$12. So I had a big bag of my clothes. I shipped it all here. So it was here when I got here. So what I'm going to do is, they have a special Takyubing service that I can ship from Onomichi to Imabari, and it arrives on the same day. Now, it is a little bit more expensive. Actually, it was kind of high, I thought. I was kind of trying to negotiate with the the front desk person. And I said, why is it so expensive? It's only like, you know, 70 kilometers. My big red bag came from Kyoto and that was only like 1400 yen. But he said that it's because it arrives on the same day, which is a convenience, right? If I send it tomorrow, I'll drop it off at front desk, maybe like at 7. And I go get my bicycle and I can start riding. And then they ship it. When I get to Imabari, my bag should be there at the guest house or the ryokan that I'm staying at. And I can keep shipping it ahead. That's one of the beauties of Japan. And you know, Japan, Takubin, their domestic shipping service is the best in the world. It's quick, it's fast, it's reasonable, it's safe, and they are actually very kind to your baggage usually. And I'm also leaving another smaller bag, like, and I also have a polar fleece jacket that I wore here today. And my jeans are too heavy to use when I'm riding. So I'm putting them in a small bag like this. And I'm returning to this hotel, the Green Hills Hotel in Onomichi. So I'm gonna leave that small bag here. I'm gonna ship my big red bag to Imabari, and then I'm gonna stay in between, and then I'll ship it back here. And then I will just be carrying mostly my camera stuff. And it's not that much, but I will have at least one of these, maybe two. So it was a lot of logistics for me. A lot of people who are young, they just carry it on their back, or they just bring the minimum and they just go. And you know, they don't ship it down because of cost, and you know, they can do it themselves. But I don't want to carry too much weight, right? Although I have so much stuff. So anyway, that's the plan and that's where I am. And I hope tomorrow I can make it without any problem. I'm a little bit nervous, but another part of me is a little excited that I haven't done this in so many years, 29 years since I've been on a bicycle cycling on kind of a longer trip, and if I can do it or not. That's the biggest pressure I feel. And as long as it doesn't rain, tomorrow's supposed to be nice, but on the return on the Wednesday, it's supposed to rain. And if it rains, then you can't really take, you know, nice video or photographs. And there's nothing worse than riding when it's raining, right? I'll see you tomorrow as when I'm on the road, and we'll see how it goes from there. It's Mike signing off from Onomichi, Hiroshima Prefecture. Until tomorrow. Arigato.